Who hasn't dreamed of eternal youth? Or at least living a long, healthy life? Wait, what if it doesn't have to be a dream? What if science can help us maximize our longevity? A new study published last month looked at factors that determine how long we get to live. The researchers focused on genetic predisposition. They found natural genetic variants linked with high cholesterol or being overweight, and they asked, are people carrying those natural variants living longer or shorter? They focused on 9 candidate factors. Diet, body weight, exercise, smoking, blood pressure, cholesterol, blood sugar, sleep, and education. Okay, those are all important for general health, but which actually determine how long we live? 4 factors stood out with the most robust effects: blood pressure, LDL cholesterol, smoking, and education. The first 3 make sense. They're major risk factors for heart disease, and that's the number 1 cause of death in our society. Education probably came out because it helps make better choices regarding lifestyle and disease prevention. If you're watching this, chances are you're mindful of your health in general, and you also read and watch several other sources on nutrition. As a result, you probably know way more than the average person about health and disease, which allows you to make better choices. Knowledge is power. In addition to those 4 top factors, the data suggested that type 2 diabetes and BMI may be life-shortening factors as well. Initially, HDL cholesterol and triglycerides also came out together with LDL cholesterol, but these blood lipid parameters all affect each other. So they tried to isolate which are really important on their own, and LDL cholesterol came out as the strongest factor. Wait, what about diet? How come that didn't pan out? That means I can eat Twinkies and drink Mountain Dew all day, right? Not so fast. They only had genetic variants predisposing for coffee and alcohol intake. So those were the only 2 dietary factors they tested. Coffee didn't affect longevity significantly. Alcohol in general didn't either, but there might be a mild life-shortening effect when we get to the level of alcohol dependence. As far as sleep, there was a suggestion of a mild effect for insomnia, but not for sleep length. Some factors were not significant, like physical activity. Yay, so I get to sit on the couch all day, right? Well, it doesn't necessarily mean that physical activity has no effect on longevity. It could just be that the genetic variants they use didn't have a strong enough effect. So at least for now, the jury is still out. The main takeaway here is to solidify the top 4 factors as major players, not only in general health, but also in determining length of life. Tobacco, blood pressure, LDL cholesterol, and education, likely representing the ability and the resources to make these choices. Longevity is thought to be 25% genes, 75% lifestyle. In the study, they focused on genetic predisposition. But in real life, whether I have good blood pressure because I'm genetically gifted or because of my lifestyle, either way, I reap the benefits. So even if we didn't win the genetic lottery, most of the prize is still ours to take. Maintaining good LDL cholesterol is mainly about going easy on concentrated sources of saturated fat, like fatty meats and butter, and conversely leaning a bit more on unsaturated fats and fiber, like avocado, flax seeds, legumes, and fruits and vegetables. If you want to include some animal products, in general, fish, lean meats, and low-fat dairy are your best bets. As for blood pressure, it hinges on the balance between potassium and sodium. So going easy on ultra-processed foods, which are the main source of sodium, and having potassium-rich foods, like leafy greens and beans. We just released a whole video on potassium-rich foods, and here's 3 simple tricks to beat your genetics and maximize your health. Thanks for watching. See you next week. Bye-bye.